This is Marilyn Lohman, Service Hydrologist at WFO Pendleton. I'll be looking at the current snowpack conditions and the expected water supply for the rest of spring and throughout the summer. Measurements of the snow water equivalent, or amount of water being held in the snowpack, were taken on May 1, 2017 for the various basins across the state of Washington. From this map, produced by the Natural Resource Conservation Service, we can see that amounts range from around 105 to 130% of normal in the upper and lower Yakima basins, as well as the lower Snake Basin. The substantial snowpack in the Cascades is located above 4,500 feet and above 5,500 feet in southeast Washington. We'll take a look at some individual stations across the region. These charts show the snow water equivalent, or water held in the snow, for the water year October through September. The blue line is the maximum observed, while the red line is the minimum, and the green line the average. Using these charts, we can see how the snow water equivalent accumulated throughout the winter and spring and compare it to average. The Touchet Snotel site is in the Walla Walla Basin around 5,500 feet. Looking at the black line, we can see that the snowpack remained nearly stable through the month and is starting to decline and remains slightly above normal. The Sassy Ridge Snowtail site is located in the upper Yakima Basin at around 4,200 feet. Looking at the black line, we can see that the snowpack peaked early in the month and is slowly decreasing with amounts near average. The Bumping Ridge Snowtail site is at around 4,600 feet in the central Washington Cascades. Once again, looking at the black line, the snow accumulation remained fairly steady through the first part of April and is decreasing but remains slightly above normal. Across Oregon, looking at the snow water equivalent map from the Natural Resource Conservation Service, as of May 1st, we can see the basins across eastern Oregon continue to have above normal snowpack for this point in the year. Amounts range from around 135% of normal for the upper Deschutes Basin to nearly 160 to 170% of normal for the Umatilla and Grande Ronde Basins, and over 200% of normal for the John Day Basin. The substantial snowpack is above 5,500 to 6,000 feet at this time. The snowpack hasn't been this high on May 1st since 2011. We'll take a look at some of the individual sites across the region. For the Northern Cascades of Oregon, the Red Hill Snowtail site is at an elevation of 4,400 feet. Looking at the black line, the current year observation, this location saw small accumulations through the month and continues to be above normal. In the Upper Deschutes Basin, the Three Creek Meadows Snowtail site is at about 5,600 feet. Looking at the solid black line, we can see this location has been seeing a gradual decrease throughout the month and is slightly below normal. For the John Day Basin, we can look at the Blue Mountain Springs site at around 5,900 feet. The snowpack has been decreasing through the month and continues to be near normal. For the Umatilla Basin in the Blue Mountains, we can look at the High Ridge site at around 4,900 feet. Looking at the black line, we can see that this snowpack decreased slightly through the month but still remains above normal. And in the Grande Ronde Basin, the Moss Springs Snowtail site is around 5,800 feet. Looking at the black line, the snowpack was nearly steady through much of the month, but a late season storm brought snow and increased the snowpack by the end of the month and pushed the site slightly above normal. The Northwest River Forecast Center uses Ensemble Stream Flow Prediction, or ESP-generated forecasts, as the official water supply method. The 30-year runoff normals cover the years 1981 to 2010 are being used. New ESP forecasts will be published on the River Forecast Center's website daily. For updated forecasts and more information about ESP forecasts, please see the River Forecast Center's website at the address given. This map from the Northwest River Forecast Center shows a snapshot of the water supply forecast for the coming season. As of the 1st of May 2017, the water supply for the Pacific Northwest looks to be near to slightly above normal, with well above normal supply expected in southern Idaho. We'll look at several stations within the area for a little more detail. For the Yakima River system, we'll look at the Yakima River near Parker. Looking at the plot, the solid green line is the 30-year normal. The box plots show the entire range of forecast values, with the blue dot the 50th percentile, or most likely value. We'll be using the 50th percentile and comparing it to normal. The volume forecast for the Yakima River near Parker for the period April through September has increased this month and is expected to be near 130% of normal. The forecasted volume of water, or the blue dot, for the Grande Ronde River near Troy is expected to be slightly above normal at 118% of normal. These forecasts take into account the expected precipitation for the next 10 days and then normal precipitation throughout the rest of the period. For the Umatilla River at Pendleton for the period April through September, the volume forecast has increased to near 117% of normal. Once again, these forecasts take into account the current 10-day forecast and then normal precipitation throughout the rest of the season. The Columbia River at the Dalles can be an indicator for the entire Columbia Basin. The average value is plotted in green, with the most likely value the blue dot. The volume for the April through September period is expected to be 126% of normal. The previous seen plots and additional water supply locations are available in an interactive form on the Northwest River Forecast Center's website at the address listed on the concluding slide. Looking ahead, the 3-month outlook from the Climate Prediction Center for May, June, and July shows increased chances of above normal temperatures across the entire Pacific Northwest and near normal precipitation expected. Here is the web address of the Northwest River Forecast Center's website where you can get the additional and updated water supply forecasts. This will be the last briefing for the current spring season, but join me again next winter as we look forward to 2018. If you have any questions, comments, or suggestions, please contact me by email or by phone. Thanks for joining me.